Please have your seat. So what we finish is only three chats, only three chats we want to see. So not just by look at the charts. So you can know what we have taught. And now we go to the fourth chart again. So we say, so just I like to review a little bit. Really show here. So we begin with the chart 4.1. So Hetu Sangaha. So the roots are here. So one root, two root, three root. So they are, if you look at the data chart, you can see them very easily. And then we come to the chart number two. So here we get how many functions? 14, remember there are 14 functions. These functions are the prisandhi, bhuminga, chuti, are performed only by vipaka chaita. So in the vipaka kolam chat number one, you can see the two upika sanina chaita, and eight mahavipaka, and then nine hegada vipaka. They perform rebirth, and then the bhuminga, life continuum, and death function. And then when the sense object appear in the sixth sense door. So to know that sense object, we have to perform these, the 11 function, 11 function we have to perform. So the name of the function and the name of the chaita are connected. So avajana function performed by panja dwara vachana, mano dwara vachana. So easy. Like dasana, seeing function, you should know they are the two eye consciousness. Savana, hearing function by two nose, tongue, ear consciousness. So this is they are connected, be easy. And soon after the eye consciousness, we get somebody chana chitta, receiving consciousness. And we say receiving function, performed by two receiving the samrita chaita, sandhina, investigating function, by three sandhina chaita, and then what tapana determining function is also performed by manodvara vachana, jhavana, a perceiving function, by 54 jhavana. So by if you just note kuku kripla, then you can answer this thing. And then the last one, registering function, by 11, the dhalamana chaita. When they perform the dhalamana, we call them the dhalamana chaita. And they are three sanina chaita and eight mahavipaka chaita. And chant number three, please. And now we talk to you about the six sense door here, five material doors and one mental door. So not in material door. So when a sense object appear, so we have these are the function actually, what we have to see there. So avajana function, seeing function, and then the hearing, the smelling, tasting, and then the body is the touching, receiving, investigating function, and the upika sanina. So they are investigating sandhina. Vatthamana is determining function. Kama jhamana, these are jhamana function, and these are the dhalamana function. So they are the 14 function here. So the chaita, what are the chaita that function this thing? So we say in the each door, of the material door, there are 46 chaita that can arise. And for the five sense door, it would be 54 kama jhavana. Only kama jhavana chaita when we are the observing the five sense objects, only kama jhavana chitta arises. So in the mind door, these sense objects can also appear in the mind door. And then when we say the six sense object, when we come to the six sense object, it appears only in the mind door. So when it appears in the mind door, Vatthapana has to apprehend it, to take notice of it and decide what it is, so whether it's good or bad. So after decision, so kama jhavana function come. So it is just the light seeing and the knowing the chaita. So it would be kama jhavana. Only when you attain jhana, megha, and phala, this apana jhavana chaita arises. And then followed by the dalamana function. And there are the dvara vimoti, 19 chaita, that are door free. They are what are the chaita? So we say those 19 chaita that performed the rebirth function, these 19, they are the door free chaita. So if you remember like that, it's not very difficult, very quite easy. And the better way is when you are study, you put the chart and then you read the description. So if you can go like that, you can see better. And actually, when we teach in the Indonesia, they have two computers. So one is the project, the text, and the other the chart. So we can see together. Now it would be better if we can do that. Yeah, now we have to say, done again. Okay, now we go to the material. So the next topic is Aramana Sangha. And remember, Aramana or Alamana. They mean sense object. They mean the same thing. And here, Chaita and Jirisika will be compiled briefly according to the sense objects. So there are the six types of sense objects. So we can read together. So when Rupa and Aramana, you combine them together, they become Rupa Aramana, visible object. And then Sadda Ramana, sound. Ganda Ramana, smell. Rasa Ramana, taste. Puttabha Ramana, tangible object. And then Dhamma Ramana, mind object. And then we give you, we say here that the mind object is, there are five kinds of them. And then the words in brackets. We say they are the ultimate materiality that stand for these sense object. So visible object is called vanna in Pali. Sound is sadda. Smell is gandha. So this gandha sadda appear here. Sanda ramana, gandha ramana. You just combine with the sense object aramana. And then the rasa is the taste. And for the tangible object, we have three ultimate materiality. Patvi, the element of solidity. Vayo, the tejo is the element of heat. And then vayo is the element of the materiality of motion, we say. Vayo, we can move. We can move. And we can touch only these three, not the abo. Abo is the materiality of liquidity. So like water. So patvi has the characteristic of hardness and softness. So you can feel the hardness here and the softness in the dimple. So this, you can see it is the patvi. And then vayo, the tejo is hotness and coolness. So if you put your hand together here, you feel the hotness here, or you can put in the armpit, so hot there, and then it's cool here. So that hotness and coolness is the tejo. And then the vayo is pushing and supporting. No, pushing. So by pushing, now we can move. No, because of this pushing, we can move. No, the hand, the legs, etc. And then supporting. Supporting means we just like that, so it doesn't fall down. You are supporting it. And also, you can stand erect. No, you can sit erect because of this supporting. So even, you know, you bend like this, you don't fall yet because you are supported, being supported. So only these can be, you know, can be felt. So they give. So the people, most of the people, and even scientists, they know only these five sense objects. No, visible objects, the sound, the smell, the taste, and tangible objects. So if you take ultimate materiality, how many materiality you get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 ultimate materiality only. No? So remember, there are altogether 28 ultimate materiality. So no, the remaining materiality are no, included in this mind objects. So we say the mind object no, consists six kinds of no, the objects here. Five prasada rupa. So you have already seen five prasada rupa as a five sense door, remember? No, five sense door, the prasada rupa, no, the prasada, translucent materiality. So no, the so it should be translucent materiality here, not transparent. No, so please, no, you change it, translucent materiality. And then if you add this five translucent materiality, and with this seven, no, the materiality, you get 12 materiality. And we call them gross materiality, just 12. No, the five sense door and the five sense object. No, the consists of 7 plus 5, 12 materiality. So if you subtract 12 no, from the 28 materiality, so you get 16 materiality. So they are called sukhuma rupa, no, subtle materiality. So these are gross materiality because they can easily understand no, as five sense object and as five sense door, easily understood. But these things are no, not easy to see and to know. So they are called sukhuma rupa, subtle materiality. So all 28 materiality are included in the six sense objects. And then also we have 89 citta, all consciousnesses are included again in the six sense object. And then 52 chittasika, all mental factors, all are also included. And also nibbana, no nibbana. And then the concept, no, such as kasina nimitta, remember we have the counter sign no, in the kasina meditation. So this kasina meditation actually no, no materiality, no, is present there. No mentality present there. They are just concept. So we say they are, no, they are. So what do you say? No, independent of time. So we say, no, the independent nibbana is also independent of time, because nibbana always exists. We don't, you know, we don't have past nibbana, present nibbana, future nibbana, no such thing. Only one nibbana, always present. No, so these are the nibbana and the concept. No, we call them the independent of time. And the mind object cannot arise at the five sense door, but it can arise in the mind door. No, now it's quite good. No, to know the six sense object. So then and now you also know in this six sense object, all materiality, all consciousnesses, all mental on the mental factors, and also nibbana and concept. No, concept are included. So everything in the universe are included. So no, we can see, we can observe all these no, the things in the universe. And we should know them all, actually. But now science know only these five sense objects. only that. No? So They should learn Abhidhamma also, the scientists and psychologists, especially philosophers. They should know the what really exists in the universe. And then if you are asked, which sense object contains the widest number of objects, it is the mind object. The mind object, it contains almost all. So, okay, now, after seeing this, we have the consciousnesses. Oh, here we give you the note, the names in brackets, we say, that we put in bracket, this vana, sadda, khanda. So these names in brackets, brackets for the five senses are the essential element, we call them. They are essential element, and they are actually the ultimate reality. And for the mind object, the sixfold object, all the six kinds of objects mentioned above are the essential element. Like we say, the all chitta, all the sukhuma, the materiality, so they are all essential element. Now, consciousness and sense object according to DAY. So now, remember, we have just seen 46 chitta arise in the eye door, in connection with the eye door, and they are known as chakhu dwarika chitta. They are aware of only present visible object only. We have already said about this. No? Okay, we already finished this. So we go to the page 101. So, okay, here. Individual consciousnesses and sense objects, So, we have the 89 chitta. So their ability to know the sense objects are different. Not like the two eye consciousness, they can be aware of only visible, only present visible object. And then, two ear consciousness, Sota vinyana dvi can be aware of only present sound. Gana vinyana dvi, nose consciousness, can be aware of only present smell. Jiva vinyana dvi, they are aware of only present taste. Kaya vinyana dvi, they are aware of only present tangible object. So, now when you go to the three manodhatu, the mind element that I have been telling you, so they consist of pancha dwara vachana, and two sambarichana. Sambarichana dvi means two sambarichana chitta. So they are called the three mind elements. And we have said that they appear all in the five senses though. So they are aware of all the above, five present sense objects. These three manodhatu. They appear in all the five though. So they are aware of all these five sense objects. And now we come to 11 dadha lamana chitta. So what are the 11 dhalamana chaita? You cannot remember, so you have to remember. So the three sandhirana chaita and eight bhavipaka chaita, we got 11 dhalamana chaita. And then hasitupada, the smiling consciousness of the arahat. They are aware of all the six karma sense objects, comprising all karma chaita, 54 karma chaita, and the 52 karma chaita sika, mental factor that associate with them. And then also all the 28 types of materiality. And this is called karma sense object. And the 12 akusala chaita, and po jnana vibhuta mahakusala chaita, and po jnana vibhuta mahakriya chaita, altogether 20 of them. They are aware of six logia. Logia mean mundane or worldly, worldly sense objects. So when we say worldly sense object, they comprise all logia chaita. Remember, they are in chart number one, we say there are 81 logia chaita, and 52 logia chaita sika. That means the mental factor that associate with this 81 logia chaita. And also all the 28 types of materiality, and also concepts. So, And then when you go to number five, can you go here? So we come to here. The four, now the jnana sambyuddha mahakusala chaita. So now the jnana sambyuddha, they are more powerful than the jnana vibhuta chaita. No? And rupa kusala abhinya. No? Are aware of all six sense objects except aratha megha and aratha phala. These objects comprise 77 chaita. So aratha megha and aratha phala being accepted, and all the 52 chaitasika that associate with them, and then, no? And then the with associate with the 87 chaita, and then 28 types of materiality, no? And also concept, no? Like the meditation sign, and also nibbana, no? So their power is very, you know, very great. And then when you go to the four mahanyana sambyuddha mahakriya chaita, remember kriya chaita arise in arahat. No, the kriya chaita are more powerful than the maha, the kusala chaita, no, the sense fear, moral consciousness. So they are, no, kriya chaita. And kriya abhinya and manodvara vajana chaita are aware of all the six sense objects. So comprising all consciousness, all chaitasika, and all the 28 types of materiality, concepts, and nibbana. So, no, they are the most powerful. And then 15 rupa vaja chaita, with the exception of abhinya dvi. So these are two abhinya chaita already mentioned here. No, so here you have what abhinya you have? We have the kriya abhinya chaita. And here we have, no, we have kusala abhinya chaita. Where it is? Kusala abhinya chaita. So, no, they are here. Kusala abhinya chaita. So accepting this, those two abhinya chaita. So, no, the 15 rupa vaja chaita, no, they, with the exception of abhinyana dvi, no, they have only concepts as their object. So concepts mean meditation sign. They take only the counter sign. They are the jhana chaita, so they focus only on the counter sign. No, so they take only one type of object. And three agasa nanjayarana chaita, and three akinchanyayarana chaita. No, so they take agasa, the agasa nanjayana chaita, they take agasa in finite space as their object, and these akinchanya, they take nothingness as their object. So, no, the infinite space and the nothingness, no, respectively for their object. And then the remaining six, no, the arupa vajara chaita, three vinyananjayana chaita, so they take only vinyana, no, and then three divasanya nasanya yarana chaita, no, they have akasanya, so, no, this vinyananja chaita, they take akasananja yarana kusala chaita or kriya chaita. So, no, when we say, no, three vinyananja yarana chaita, so they mean, no, vinyananja yarana kusala chaita, vinyananjayarana vipaka chaita, vinyananjayarana kriya chaita. So kriya chaita arise only in the arahats. So they would take only, you know, the for arahats, they would take the kriya chaita, no, as their object. And akinchanyayarana, remember, no, they take nothingness as their, no, as their object. Akinchanya. So this akinchanya jana chaita is taken by this three nivasanya nasanya yarana chaita. No? So, and then eight logudara chaita have nibbana as their object. No? Only nibbana. And then those 19 pratisandhi chaita, rebirth consciousness. 19 buinga chaita, life continuum. 19 chuti chaita, death consciousness. They take the near death sign, marana sana namita, of the immediate past life, as their object. So this nimitta may be in the form of karma and sign of karma or sign of destiny. And we shall explain this sign, no, the later on. So we have a chart again for this, no, or for this. So chart number five, no, chart number five. So 5.1 we call it. So now what we have read there is now described here. So how can you read it? So in your book, no, what we have read already is already the reading of this chart, what we have just, no, read. So we say tu chakhu vinyana, no, they take only present visible object. And tu soda vinyana chaita, they can see only, they can know only present sound. Tu ghana vinyana can be, no, only present smell. Tu jiva vinyana, only present taste. And then tu kaya vinyana, they are aware of only, no, the tangible object, no, the present tangible object. So these ten, no, the chitta, they are aware of present five sense objects. No, these five, the ten chitta. And then we have the manodhatu, remember we have just read, the mind, no, the mind element. If you, we dhatu means element. And then they consist of panca dharavajana and the two samarichana chaita. They are aware of all these five present sense objects. And then 11 the dalamana and hasitupada, no, so 12 of them can be aware of all, no, six karma sense objects. So comprising 54 karma chaita and 52 chaitasika associated with them and all materiality, 28. No, they are called six karma sense objects. So if you combine these three, 10, 3, 12, you get 25. So we call them karma ekan. Ekan means one. They are, no, they are aware of only karma sense objects. So these are only karma sense objects. No? So these are included here. No? They are included here. So these chaita, no, they can be aware of all these six karma sense objects. Then we go down, 12 agusala chaita, and then, no, 4 maha kusala jnana vibhuta. So jnana vibhuta is with, no, is not associated with wisdom. And then also 4 maha kriya jnana vibhuta chaita. So altogether 20 of them. So they are aware of 6 logia sense object. So remember, 6 logia chaita, no, they are aware of the all the 81 logia chaita, mundane consciousnesses, and all mental factor, 52 mental factor associated with them, and all materiality, and all concept. Remember, all these are included in these, no, in these, this chaita included in these. So you just combine the 27 mahagata chaita, you get 81 logia chaita, no. So, no, the chaita, no, they are aware of 6 logia sense object. And then mahakusala jnana sambhuta chaita. So I said, no, they are more powerful than mahakusala jnana vibhuta, without wisdom. And then 4 rupa kusala abhinya. Abhinya is supernormal, no, the knowledge. So the 4 rupa kusala chaita, no, with, when it is associated with these, the supernormal knowledge, we call them rupa kusala abhinya. So these 5 chaita, no, they can be aware of all 6 sense objects except arata megha and arata phala. So we say all chaita except arata megha, arata phala, 87, all chaitasika associated with them, and 28, no, materiality. And concept is a meditation sign, like the counter sign, and nibbana. So, no, these 5. And then when you come to this, no, this group, so now, again, no, instead of the mahakusala, now we get mahakriya, jnana sambhuta, 4 of them, and then kriya abhinya, no, kriya abhinya, and then mano dwara vachana. six chaitta, they can be aware of all six sense objects, consisting of all chaitta, all jitasika, all rupa, all concept and nibbana. No, they are actually the most powerful. So now if we add this 25, 6, we get 31. So no, they are aware of no, the karma chaitta. So we say here, no, the karma chaitta, these are 54 chaitta. They are aware of karma chaitta. And also Mahakata Chaita, so Mahakata Chaita 27 are included here, and also included here, and also concept, no concept. So they are aware of, so they, we call them Anekan Chaita, no 31 Anekan Chaita. Anekan mean they can take more than one type of sense object. No, here is only Kama sense object. Here is not only Kama sense object, also Mahakata sense object, and concept. And then if you look at these two, no, here, so these no, 11 chaitta, they can be aware of Nibbana also. No? So Nibbana, Anekan, chaitta, 11 of them. So that means they can be aware of Nibbana as well as other sense objects. No? So they are called no, Nibbana, Anekan, sense object. So no, you might say, how can Mahakusala, no, Jnana Samyutta Chaita, and then Mahakriya Jnana Samyutta Chaita, no, they can be aware of no, the Nibbana. So no, the, when we come to the, no, the chapter 5, we will see that how they can be aware of no, the next chapter, no, we can see that. So now we go to up to here. So we say 15 rupa vajra chaitta. Now without the two abhinya, no, the two abhinya, they can be aware of only concept, that is the countersigns of these meditation objects. These are 26 meditation objects. Now that can give rise to rupa vajra jhana. Remember 10 kasina, no, and 10 asupa. No, 10 asupa is the 10 types of corpses, no, human corpses. And then kaya, no, kaya kata sati. So no, by this the Buddha can ask you to analyze the whole body into 32 parts. No, so that's kaya kata sati. Anapanasati is mindfulness of breathing. And then Brahma vihara is no, sublime, no, sublime living. So they consist of mitta, no, the metta, loving kindness, kruna, compassion, and then mudita, sympathetic joy, and then the equanimity, no, the so all the four of them. Now and then among the 12, no, these are the 12 the arupa vajra kusala chaita, no, 12 arupa vajra chaita. So among these 12, 3 akasa nanjayana chaita, no, they take akasa, no, as their object. And 3 aginjanyayarana chaita, they take nothingness, no, nothingness as their object. And then these 3 vinyananjayarana chaita, so they take vinyana. Vinyana here is this akasananjayarana kusala chaita. So for arahat, they will take the kriya chaita as the object, no. And then neva sanyana sanyayarana chaita, no, 3 of them. So they, no, they take this akinjanyana chaita as their object. So these are mahakata, no, the chaita. So we call them, no, they take mahakata ekan. Mahakata ekan means, so this is the 21 arupa, this chaita. No, they take only concept, the concept. So we call them panyati ekan. Concept, it's called panyati in Pali, no. So they take only one, no, this object, no, that is the concept. So these 6 objects, consciousness, they take only Mahakata Chaita, no, as their object. So we call them Mahakata Ekan. And the 8 Lokutra Chaita, no, 4 part consciousness and 4 fruition consciousness, they take Nibbana only. So we call it Nibbana Ekan. So how many Chaita that can be aware of Nibbana? Here 8 Nibbana Ekan, here 11 Nibbana Anekan, altogether 19 Chaita. And then we say, no, this rebirth consciousness and Bhavinga Chaita and Chuti, no, the Chuti Chaita, no, 19 each, they are aware of the near-death sign of our past existence. So just before we die in the past existence, no, the near-death sign always appear. No, near-death sign will appear. And we will explain to you later. So they take, you know, that near-death sign in the form of karma, the karma that produce this present existence, no, appear in the mind door. And then karma namita. So no, the when that karma does not appear, the sense object when you perform that action is called karma namita, no, they appear. No, like you pay homage, no, to the Buddha statue. So if that karma, the moral karma, while you are paying, no, the homage, has a chance to bear risa. So you can see that Buddha statue, that is called karma namita. And then gadi namita is, no, the sign of destiny, we call it. Gadi is sign of destiny. So where you are going to be reborn, no, when you die from the past existence, so where you are going to reborn, so no, those signs will appear. So if you are born in the human realm, usually you see the mother's, no, the womb as red velvet, red velvet. And then you can also see human houses and human person, no, when you are when you are going to be born in the human realm. If you are going to be reborn in celestial realm, you will see celestial being, celestial mansion, etc. If you are going to be born in hell, you will see the hell denizen being, no, the torture and the hell hounds, etc. So these are called, no, sign of destiny. So now we finish this one. So far so good. No? To explain to you so that you can understand, you can remember the past, no? So, and then you have to read, no? And then you have to see. Not only then you can remember them very well. So we can go to the next, no, the topic. So we say Vattu Sangha, no? So here we call sign of destiny, no? The karma, the sign of karma or sign of destiny. And now we call Vattu Sangha. No, there are six physical bases, no, depending on which consciousness and mental factors arise. No, remember, no, the consciousness and mental factor, no, they are very, very delicate, no, very subtle. So they cannot arise, no, by themselves. They have to depend on the material base, no, to arise. And then they have all those to cling to a visible, to a sense object. No, to clinging to a sense object, and also depending on the material base, only then it can arise. Now, no, the five, the Vattu is again, no, the familiar to you, because they are again the five Pasada Rupa. No, translucent material, remember? No, they are also the eye door, the ear door, the nose door, the tongue door, the body door. We have seen them as the five sense door. Now you see them as five, no? So eye base, ear base we call now. So Chakku Vattu is Chakku Pasada, it is the eye base. Soda Vattu is Soda Pasada, the ear base. Gana Vattu, Gana Pasada, the nose base. Jiva Vattu, Jiva Pasada, the tongue base. Kaya Vattu, Kaya Pasada, the body base. And Hadya Vattu, no, physical base, that exists in the blood of the heart, and it is called the heart base. So now again, among this, the six Vattu, the heart base is the most important, because not only two eye consciousness will depend on this, the eye base, two ear consciousness will depend on the ear base, but all, no, the so except these 10 consciousnesses, all the remaining consciousness, they depend on the heart base for their arising. No? So they are important again. And now we give you, no, the five physical bases are the five Pasada materiality, no, the translucent materiality, Whereas the sixth one is the heart base. No, the heart base exists in the blood of the heart. In the blood of the heart. So all these materiality, they are produced by karma, karma-born materiality. No, so no, the karma that produces our existence, no, is very important for us. No, all this materiality, no, they produced by the karma. And now they give you, no, the summary of striking image. So I have been, no, telling you about striking image. So the match is the striking element. No, the match stick is the striking element. And in the rough surface of the matchbox is we call the receiving element. So when you strike the matchstick on the, no, the matchbox, you get the flame. No, so the flame, no, the flame is the resultant element. Now the flame does not exist anywhere, no, before striking the match. When the conditions for its arising are fulfilled, the flame arises. So in the same way, no, the visible object is the striking element, and the eye door is the receiving element. And no, when the eye consciousness is the resulting element. So we say when eye con the visible object, no, strike the eye door, or appear in the eye door, then eye consciousness arises. Not just like the flame arises here, eye consciousness arises here. So the eye consciousness does not exist before or after, no, the contact between visible object and the eye door. It arises just at the time of contact and then perishes. So these consciousness, they arise and perish, arise and perish. So now they don't exist anywhere. So if you ask, where consciousness exists, they don't exist anywhere. Because as soon as they arise, they finish. No, and they arise when conditions are fulfilled. No, when the sense object come in contact with the sense door. At that time, no, the consciousness arises. And then after arising, it perishes. No? Okay. Now the eye transparent materiality, Chakkhupasada, is the door through which visible object enters the mind. So Chakkhupasada is called Chakkhudwara, no? That is the eye door. Then the eye consciousness, together with its, no, the associated seven mental factors, no? So they arise at the point of contact. No, that is on the Chakkhupasada. No, the point of contact is on Chakkhupasada. No, that we call the eye door. So depending on Chakkhupasada as the physical base. So when the eye consciousness arises, they need to depend on a material base. So which material base they will depend on? As they arise on the Chakkhupasada, which is also called material base, eye base. So they depend on this eye base. No? So Chakkhupasada as a physical base, thus Chakkhupasada is also known as the eye base. So Chakkhupasada is known both as the eye door and as the eye base. The same thing is true for the other four sense organs or pasada rupa. Each pasada rupa function as a sense door as well as the physical base. So, it is easy, not difficult. No? Now we go to the physical basis in three spheres. So in three spheres mean, no, the sense sphere is kama loka, no, kama sense sphere. And then, so we have, in the 11 kama planes, so no, the Kama, 11 karma plane mean karma is the karma realm, you might say. So what are the 11 karma realm? Four woeful boats, no? And human realm, five, six celestial realm, no? The 11 karma realm. So we have, no, in this 11 karma plane, no? That is the sense sphere, all the six know, physical basis what to exist. So we, you know, we have also all the six physical bases. And in the five material sphere, that is Rupa Loka or Rupa Brahma realms, only three physical bases, namely Chakku Vattu, not the eye base, Sota Vattu, the ear, the ear base, and Hadya Vattu exist. Only three material base exist. So the reason is, during the Samatha Bhavana, tranquility meditation, you know, to enter upon the Rupa Jhana, to develop the Jhana, the meditator has to give up the enjoyment of sensual pleasure. So when you are meditating, well, you know, to develop the Jhana, you have to give up. You know, you should not enjoy sensual pleasure. Why? during those meditation. So by controlling his mind not to wander around sense objects. So when we say, you know, sense pleasure, so your mind is going around, you know, various sense objects. So when the jhana, kusala kama, conditions them, so when you attain the jhana, and you get the jhana, kusala kama, and when they give rise to, you know, to the Brahma, the Brahma, so all we say, the conditions, the meditator, to be reborn in the Rupa Brahma realm. He is not endowed with Gana Vattu, no, the nose base, Jiva Vattu, the tongue base, and Kaya Vattu, the body base, as no enjoyment of sense pleasure exists there. So Rupa Brahma, no, when we develop the Rupa Jhana, no, we have to give up, no, enjoyment of the sensual pleasure. So, now when this Rupa Kama, no, Rupa Kama, produce them as Rupa Brahma, so in the Rupa Brahma realm, no enjoyment of sense pleasure. No, because of this, the result of this the meditation. And now, but however, they need eyes, they want to get eyes to see the Buddha. No? And then they also need ears to listen to the Dhamma. And they need Hadya Vattu for the arising of, no, the Mano Vijnana Chaita. So Mano Vijnana Chaita, no, are all the consciousness, you know, except the ten Dvi Pancha Vijnana. We call them Mano Vijnana Chaita. And all the associated mental factors, no, they depend on they need the heart base for the arise, you know, in the Rupa Brahma realm. So the Rupa Brahma realm, no, they have only three Vattu. What are they? They have only three Vattu, three physical bases. So, no, eye base, ear base, and then, no, the heart base, no, the heart base. So they need the eye base, no, for Chakku Vijnana to depend on to arise. And then Chakku Vattu, no, is actually Chakku Prasada, so it is also the eye door as well as the eye base. And Sota Vattu is Sota, no, the ear door as well as the ear base. No, only when they are present, no, like the visible object can appear in the ear door, and then the sound can appear, no, in the nose door, and then, no, when eye consciousness rises, it can depend on the eye base, and the ear consciousness, when it arises, it depends on the ear base. And then Hadya Vattu, no, for all the other chitta to depend on. So they have only three Vattu. Now, so we finish up to here, no? In the immaterial sphere, that is Arupa Ram, Arupa Brahma Ram, no Vattus exist. Because no materiality exists there. Again, due to the meditation power of Samatha meditation, to enter, to develop arupa jhana. So remember when we developed arupa jhana, we have to reflect on the force, of materiality, and we don't give attention to materiality. So remember, the material, all material of the 12 arupa vajra chaita, what object they take? Akasa, we have just finished. So they take akasa, and then nothingness, and then they take mahakata chaita, as their object. So they don't take materiality as the object anymore. So because of that power of meditation, when they become arupa jhana, no materiality, only minds, only minds arise there. And then and because of this meditation power also, the arupa brahma realm, their chaita can arise without depending on the material base. They can arise without depending on material base. Now we have another the topic, consciousness element, vijnana dhatu, consciousness element. So all the 89 chaita, all 89 chaita, in the brief method. So now we see here, vijnana means chaita, consciousness. And then dhatu means element. So they are consciousness element, these are the consciousness element. So we say, so that which carries the element means, element means, dhatu element means, that it carries its own characteristic, but it is not a living being. It is not a living being. So to show that consciousness is not a living being, the Buddha, he classified consciousness into seven the consciousness element, altogether seven of them. Now again, it is not very difficult again. So the two eye consciousness, we call them chakhu vijnana dhatu. So the direct translation, eye consciousness element. So they represent the two eye consciousness, and they depend on the eye base for their arising. The two eye consciousness. And the same thing, sota vijnana dhatu is ear conscious element. They represent the two ear consciousnesses, and they depend on the ear base for their arising. Gana vijnana dhatu, nose conscious element. So they represent the two nose consciousness which depend on nose base for their arising. Jiva vijnana dhatu, tongue consciousness element. So they represent two tongue consciousness which depend on tongue base for their arising. Kaya vijnana dhatu, body consciousness element. So they represent two body consciousnesses which depend on body base for their arising. So how many chaita do you have here? ten dvi panja vijnana. Ten dvi panja vijnana. Now mano dhatu, the mind element comes here. So we already know mind element mean panja dvara vajana chaita and the two samparijana chaita. These three are called mind element. So 10 plus 3, out of the 13. How many left? So these are more mind element. They depend also on the heart base for their arising. So the remaining, 89 minus 13, you get 676. And we call them mano vijnana dhatu. Mano dhatu, mano vijnana dhatu, mind consciousness element. So the remaining 76 chaita, they also depend on the heart base for their arising. Okay. Now, we come to classification of consciousness according to the physical base again. Okay, we have to read again and then we have to see the chart later. So for you can see the chart before you. So there in the chart, there are 10 chaitas. which always depend on Panchavattu. Panchavattu means the five material bases, mini, namely, no, Chakuvattu, the eye base, Sodavattu, ear base, Kanavattu, nose base, Jivavattu, Kayavattu. No, the ten Dvipanja Vinyana Chitta actually. For the arising, so they are ten Dvipanja Vinyana Chitta. So we call them Dvipanja Vinyana, no, ten consciousnesses. And then there are three Chitta, no, that is three Chitta, which always depend on Hadyavattu, no, the heart base, for the arising. They are two dosa mula chaita, three manodhatu, no, the mind element, no, we have just seen. And then three sandhina chaita, and then no, the hasi tupada chaita, no, the smiling consciousness of the arahat. Eight mahavipaka chaita, and 15 rupa vajra chaita, and one sotapati mega chaita. No? So these are the chaita, no, that, so they always depend on Hadyavattu, no, for their arising. The reason is, no, these chaita do not arise in the Arupa Brahma. No, they arise in the sense sphere and the Rupa Brahma realm. So, no, in Rupa Brahma realm and you on the sense sphere, we have materiality. So they depend on the heart base, no. And then 42 chaita, which sometimes depend on the heart base and sometimes do not depend on the heart base for the arising. So the reason is this 42 chaita also arise in Arupa Brahma. No? So when they arise in Arupa Brahma, they have no materiality, no heart base, so they don't depend on the heart base. But they also arise, no, in the sense sphere and the Rupa Brahma realm, then they would depend on the heart base. No? So sometimes they depend on heart base, sometimes they don't depend on heart base. So what are they? 10 Akusala Chaita except the 2 Dosa Mula Chaita. We already take the 2 Dosa Mula Chaita here. No? So except that. So, and then the 8, no? So what are the 10? Akusala chaita with the exception to dosa mula chaita, 8 lobha mula chaita, and 2 moha mula chaita. Okay, and then 8 maha kusala chaita. No, because Arupa Brahma, they also, no, perform the meritorious deed, so they have also maha kusala chaita. And also Mahakriya Chaita, because arahats also are born in the Arupa Brahma realm. So they have 8 Mahakriya Chaita. And 4 Arupa Vajra Kusala Chaita. No? So, and then 4 Arupa Vajra Kriya Chaita for arahat. And 7 Lokuttara Chaita, except Sotapatti Mega Chaita. No? Mega, Sotapatti Mega Chaita cannot arise, no, in the Arupa Brahma realm. And then Mano Dvara Vajana Chaita. No? So it is also essential, no, to be aware of sense object, Mano Dvara Vajana, or no, that apprehend, to take notice of the sense object and to decide whether the sense object is good or bad. So they also arise in the Arupa Brahma realm. And the reason, no, Sotapatti Mega does not arise in the Arupa Brahma realm is that, no, those, no, the Wallings, no, Wallings are not noble person yet, no, they have a lot of the defilement with them. So all of us are Wallings, no, all of us are Walling. So now when we attain Arupa Brahma, the Arupa Jhana, so remember, no, by meditating on at Kasina. So nowadays, no, many people can develop Arupa Jhana in the Park Meditation Center. So, no, if they can remain, no, maintain this, the Arupa Jhana, and they die, they will be reborn in Arupa Brahma realm. As Walling, if you die Walling, you will be born only Walling there. No? So, and when you are born as Walling in Arupa Brahma realm, you cannot undertake meditation. You cannot do meditation. You remember, you have only the mind, no body. So for meditation, you have to not the to see both mentality and materiality, and also not as they have that they only the mind, they cannot travel. So they cannot travel. So they cannot see the Buddha. No, so they and also they cannot hear the Dhamma. So no, they cannot do meditation. So they cannot develop Sotapatti Megha Chaitta. But those, you know, the Srimvena, no, in the human realm and the celestial realm, who are Srimvena, and when they attain the Arupa Jhana, they die, they can be reborn in the Arupa Brahma realm as Srimvena. So, no, when you are Srimvena, you are never, no, the become the worldlings again. No, always you will grow up, no, not fall down. So, and also, no, the once returner, non returner. So, no, these people, no, if they attain Arupa Jhana, they can be reborn in the Brahma realm as, no, as the stream winner, as the once returner, as the non returner. And when you the stream winner, no, the are born there, they can automatically attain the higher, not the higher part wisdom. So they can attain, no, the Skadagami Megha, and then become Skadagam, the once returner. And then they can also attain the Anagami Megha and become non-returner. And they can be attain Arahat, and they can become Arahat, and they, from there they can go to Nibbana when they die. So we say, no, all the other, no, the altogether, no, the, there are four part person and four fruition person. Why you are having the Sotapatti Megha Chaitta is arising in you? You are called Sotapatti part person, no, part person. But Sotapatti part person, no, they exist only for why that Sotapatti Megha Chaitta arises, just a moment, very short moment. Only then, after that, you get Sotapatti Phala Chaitta, become Sotapanna. No? So, the four-part person, we cannot see them. No? They exist only for one conscious movement, one consciousness. No? Why that consciousness arising? So, as when you become the Purushan Chaitta, then you become the Phala person, they are called, no, the Srimvena, once returner, non-returner, and arahat. No, so altogether seven, no, the part seven. So we say here, Sotapatti Megha being accepted, also only we say that, no, and they can attain all the higher, no, the higher, the three part person, and then the four fruition person can exist in the. So we are so seven Lokottara Chaitta, we say, no, can exist there. Okay, finish for this. So we go to the table 5.2. So below this, so this is the table we have just read. So now you can see, no, name of what two material base are given here. So what are the material base? Chakuvatu is the eye base, ear base, nose base, tongue base, body base, and Hadyavatu is the heart base. So six heart base, and then this Hadya, the Hadya sometime. So the okay. So these are, no, these are the Chaitta. So remember, they include 12 immoral mind, 18 ruthless consciousnesses, 24 Kama Sovana Chaitta. So these are 54, no, Kama Chaitta. And we have 15 Rupa Vajra Chaitta, 12 Arupa Vajra Chaitta, 8 Lokottara Chaitta in the brief method. So all are 89 Chaitta, no, 89 Chaitta. So, okay, How do we read? So as you have already read. So how do you read? So we say, you know, the two eye consciousness depend on the heart base, and two ear consciousness depend on the ear base, two nose consciousness depend on the tongue base, and two tongue consciousness depend on the tongue base, two kaya vinyana depend on the body base. So these ten theta, they always depend on the, you know, on the material base for their arising. And then, now we say, there are 33 chaita that always, you know, depend on the heart base for their arising. So, you know, we have read like that. So what are they? The two dosa mula chaita, you know? And then, three manodhatu, mind elements, three sandhidana chaita, and then hasitupada, you know, the smiling of the arahat. And then mahavipaka, eight mahavipaka, no, eight mahavipaka chaita, no, actually, no, it arises only in human beings and the celestial being. No, they are the rebirth consciousness, life continuum, and death consciousness of human beings and celestial beings. But they also function as the dalamana chaita. No, so they depend on handiyavatu for their arising. And then 15 rupa vajra, no, jhana, that arise in arupa brahma, in rupa brahma. Remember, rupa brahma have the materiality, the heart base, so they will depend on the heart base for their arising. And then, no, so body mega chaita, no, so they have to depend, no, they do not arise in the arupa realm, so they arise only in other realm where materiality is present. So they always depend on the heart base, 33 of them. So this 42, no, they sometimes depend on heart base, sometimes do not depend on the heart base. So we say 10 akusala chaita with the exception of 2 dosa mula chaita, no? So 8 lobha mula and 2 moha mula. And then manodvara vachana, no, they need it for their, no, for the cognitive series to arise. And then, eight mahagusala, they also perform meritorious deeds. So, eight mahagusala chaita arise, and also eight mahakriya chaita, no, as arahat, no, they arise. And remember, no, rupa vajra chaita, no, do not arise in arupa brahma. Arupa brahma, why? Rupa vajra, the chaita, what do they take as their object? Meditation sign, counter sign, no? So they can do, but they cannot, the arupa jama cannot perform meditation, we told you. So these, the 15 rupa jana do not arise in them. And then, 4 arupa vajra kusala chaita, of course, arise in them. And then, 4 arupa vajra kriya chaita, as the arahat arupa brahma, no, they will have this arupa kriya chaita. And then we say the higher mega and phala chaita, no, so 7 of them, so except the sotapati mega, no, so the remaining 7 can arise in arupa brahma, so they amount to 42. And this arupa vajra, no, vipaka chaita, no, they function as rebirth consciousness, life continuum, and death consciousness only in Brahma, in arupa Brahma. So, no, they will never depend on the anyvatu for their arising. No, as arupa Brahma do not have materiality, so, no, these are the 4, no, which do not depend on anyvatu for their arising. Okay, no, we finish this. So what remains? What remains? Classification of consciousness according to physical base. So we finish this? No? So we finish chapter 3. So, no? So we can continue with the chapter 4. No? Don't do tomorrow, time is very precious. So now we have only 10 days to teach you. We should finish at least half of the book, so that the next time we can finish. Just 5 minutes. Just to have the taste of cognitive series. So what is cognitive series? No? So if you know that, it's quite good. So we say, process of consciousness. Viti means a chain of consciousness, or cognitive series we call it. No? Cognize means to know. Cognize. Cognitive series is a series of consciousness to know the sense object. No? That arises when a sense object appears at one of the sense door, in order to be aware of that sense object. No, a series of the consciousness have to arise. Now, as the road passes one village after another, without skipping nor changing the order of the villages, so also the consciousnesses. No, they arise one after another in the order they should, according to the law of consciousness, citta niyama. Actually, the order they arise is the order of those 11 functions of citta. No? 11 functions of citta. And now the lifespan of consciousness. No? It's good to know it. So you can read, consciousness arise and dissolve or perish in a person at a tremendous rate of more than 1,000 billion per eye wing or per snap of the hand. So the lifespan of consciousness is less than 1,000 billion of a second. So very, very short. So the lifespan or duration of consciousness is measured by three sub-movements of the distinct features in the arising and passing away of the consciousness. So upada means the genetic sub-movement. Genetic, or you can say the arising sub-movement. And titi is the existing sub-movement. And benga is the dissolving sub-movement. So these three sub-movements, in Pali we call khana, are said to be equal to one consciousness movement. No, the lifespan of one consciousness, actually. And that consciousness movement we call chaitakana. And that is the lifespan of one consciousness. No? So, all the chaita, they have arise, exist, perish. Arise, exist, perish. No? Also we have, this is arising and existing and perishing. So these are the three sub-movements. It's called one conscious movement, and which is the lifespan of a consciousness. So we say, so the lifespan of a consciousness is equal to three sub-movements of arising, existing, and perishing of the chaita, or it is equal to one consciousness movement, or one chaitakana. One chaitakana is better represented by one consciousness movement, rather than a thought movement. Some people they translate as a thought movement. So it is not correct. No, it is one conscious movement. It's the right one. No? Now, the duration of one conscious movement will be, so we can just, it's not necessary. Okay, now it's 10 a.m., 10 p.m., that we can stop. No? Okay. Imaya dhammanu dhamma padipatiya buddham bujemi. Imaya dhammanu dhamma padipatiya dhammam bujemi. Imaya dhammanu dhamma padipatiya Sangham Bujimbi, with our holy practice, which is in accord with the nine supramundane dhammas, we pay obeisance to the Buddha, the Dhamma, and the Sangha. Idam me punyam asvekhaya vaham hotu. Idam me punyam nibbanasa pachaya hotu. Inan no buja bhagam sabha saddhanam dema. Imam no buja bhagam sabha saddhanam dema. Imam no buja bhagam sabha saddhanam dema. We share our merits with all sentient beings. May all sentient beings obtain the share of our merits and be well and happy always. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. And what are the nine supramundane dhamma? What are the nine supramundane dhamma? Four-part wisdom, four-fruition wisdom and nibbana. No, they are called the nine supramundane dhammas. And they are the noblest dhammas because they can not totally eliminate all defilements from the mind. So what we are doing is, in accord with these nine supramundane dhamma, to attain this dhamma, now we are learning abhidhamma. So please try to learn well. So, and may you be enlightened in due time. Okay.